Today, I talk about we live in a society. We talk about patriarchy. And without knowing, there's a dominance of the male over female. And the dominance of masculinity and ableism. Disabilities, I call it a form of social oppression involving restriction in the activities of people with impairment and the socially endangered, undermining the psycho-emotion well-being. Why do I say we have impairment, we have limitation, but we are disabled by the society, the structure, and the attitude. There are two forms of disability: psychosocial, emotional, and structural. The structural is more evident. It's in the society. We can see that. It's obvious. But the psycho-emotional is located within the oppressive relationship, and it's more covert than obvious. And again, without knowing, we imbibe it. It becomes a part of us. We internalize this oppression. You may ask why I use the word disability and not the word disability. Because disability has a much broader connotation. It encompasses the other form of oppression that people with disabilities face, like heterosexism, racism, ageism. It's layered. It's just not one form of oppression. There are multiple dimensions. Why did I talk about all this? I just said it to link with my life experience. I was born with cerebral palsy, and at that time, as Shri N.D just told you, many people knew what cerebral palsy was. But I was lucky. I had supportive parents who found Shri N.D. And I was admitted to her school. But apart from this, I lived a very so-called normal life. So-called. I lived in a building complex, and I had my friend of my age, and when I was growing up, like any other teenager, people fell in love, people had crushes, and I had to be a part of all this. I had to be with them, but somewhere there was a limit. There was an invisible barrier to my sexuality. I was then a disabled girl. Sometimes the word inclusion has its fallacy. It is somewhat superficial, a pseudo-term, and sometimes it carries load of charity with it. But an added teenager with disability facing a so-called non-disabled society with non-disabled peers. There was a variety of feelings, and none of them can be said, quote unquote, right or wrong. But to survive, we develop our own coping mechanism, which envies self-denial that you cannot nurture in romantic feeling or aspiration. This is not your job. You don't belong to this world. And when you are in this situation, you try to distance yourself internally from the world where you are physically present, and unknowingly you diminish your self-esteem. And I went through all these processes, and I just told you, as a teenager, I went through a process of self-denial, denying that I was a sexual being, denying that I was a girl who could be admired. And my sexual desires were a big something that had to be skillfully ignored. And I had heard comments like this, that I would have been attracted to her if she wasn't like that. Similar. And then as I grew up, I went to college, and there the situation became more complex. No doubt I had friends who supported me, but at one level somewhere I was isolated, and I was made painfully conscious about my disability. And as I said, a big sexuality that I never felt that I don't need to be appreciated as a woman. I don't have the right to change romantic relationship. I don't have the right to get attention from a friend. Especially if the person is male. And these are the restrictions set by society imposed on our infirmity. And these are invisible. We cannot see that. These are not obvious. And in this situation, many people like me the tendency to go into depression. Or the psychological problem. And the third is, some people completely neglect their impairment, which I did at one point, and I admit now, but I realized I was wrong, and having realized that, I became an advocate, a self-advocate for people with disability and for people like us. And I became deaf fellow being. So I come back to the fact that in my opinion, this disparity is somewhat rooted in the patriarchal system in which we live, we are the part of. It's a play of power structure that operates in the society. Disability is actually an offshoot of this patriarchy. Ableism, but disability, probably leading to structural and psycho-emotional oppression. So I end here.